The time filter tool from TravelTime can be used to do a couple of things. It can be used to filter points into reachable and unreachable based on a given maximum travel time to or from a location. And also it can be used to create travel time matrices. So lots of origins, lots of destinations, and calculating the travel time between each pair. There are a couple of ways to run this tool. The simplest way is to use this Quicktime filter tool in the toolbar. So if we select or open up a layer of points that we want to filter based on a travel time from a certain location, we can open up the Quicktime filter tool, choose our transport type. So if we go with public transport, our cutoff travel time, so say we want to find any that are within 2 hours. We want these journeys to arrive at 9:30 in the morning. And then we can either put an address in here, or we can simply click on the map. So if we put an address in and hit this geocode icon, what happens is the tool turns this address into a lat long, which is marked as this little cross. And it then calculates the travel times from that point to all of these 500 locations and filters them for whether they're within 2 hours or not within 2 hours by public transport at that time of day. So you can see they're colored for reachable and unreachable. And if we open up the attribute table, for each of those 500 locations, so here you can see we had, these were employee IDs and with an address. We have a lot of geocoded information here that we can ignore. But on the far right-hand side, we have this property travel time field. And this is the time in seconds by public transport from that address that we entered into the dialog box to each of these locations. And it only displays them for the ones that are reachable. So these nulls are the points that were outside of that 2 hour cutoff. So if you wanted to find as many of these as possible, you can set the cutoff to 4 hours, which is the maximum. And then any journeys that are within 4 hours, it will return a travel time for those. So actually I will just show what that looks like. Say we wanted to do a 4 hour driving cutoff, say 240 minutes. This time we'll run it just by clicking on the map. Say we click our origin here. As you can see, we've got far more marked as reachable now. And again, if we open up the attribute table, same idea. We have this travel time field, and now we'll have far more of these with a travel time rather than null values. For walking, cycling, and driving, we also get this distance field returned. So this is the distance in meters, and it's not the straight line distance, that's the distance traveled along the road. So yeah, if it's not just travel time you're interested in, if it's driving distance, say for calculating CO2 emissions, then this is also provided for all of those reachable points. Another way to run the time filter tool is off two layers. So one layer of points as your origins and one layer of points as your destinations. And this is kind of creating that classic origin destination matrix. So if I load up another layer of points here, we now have 500 locations and 10 locations. And we want to calculate the travel time between each of those. So all 5,000 travel times, essentially. We can go into our travel time platform area of the processing toolbox, open up simplified, and go to time filter simple. And here there are just a few fields to configure. So under searches, we select the layer normally with the fewest points. So we're going to go with our 10 locations layer. we can calculate these travel times based on departing these 10 locations or arriving at these 10 locations. So say we want to depart these 10. We want public transport times. We want to leave at 5:30 in the evening. We can select a time zone. Here we can set a travel time limit to mark them as reachable and unreachable. However, in this case, I want to basically calculate as many of these as possible to get as full a matrix of travel times as we can. So I set the maximum value, which is 4 hours, or 240 minutes. In locations, we select the layer with the most points. So we put our 10 locations as searches and our 500 locations as locations. There's also an option here to load fare information. So this is only currently available in the UK. But if we tick this box, then in our output, we'll not only get the travel time between each of these points, but also the public transport fare between each of those points. But we'll leave that for now. And we hit run. So this may take a few seconds to complete because it's going through all 5,000 travel times. It's almost there now. So now it's completed. And this gives us a couple of things. First of all, it marks them as reachable and unreachable. But that's not actually kind of what we're looking for with this tool. What we want is the attribute table. And in this attribute table, for each of our of those 10 locations and each of our 500 locations, so these different addresses or employee IDs, for each pair of those, essentially, we get, for any that are reachable, a travel time. So this is where the tool is incredibly powerful. So it's calculated thousands of these travel times in a matter of seconds. And then you can just copy this table, put it into Excel or something, run a pivot on it, and then you can get your origins along the top and your destinations along the side and have a matrix of travel times. You could similarly do that for fares or for walking, driving, and cycling. You could do that for distances. So you could get a matrix of the driving distances between all of these points, or the cycling distances between all of these points. And that's how to use the time filter tool from TravelTime.